Well, we see if we do a search for how to save file for Prepress and Illustrator, the first return in Google is a Markzware, particular FlightCheck, which is vital for Illustrator users for not only preflighting your work before outputting, but also allowing you to package all artwork and fonts used within your file for archiving and or for sending to next party in the workflow. Okay, so let's pop into Illustrator CS5 in this case. So open up this file and I'll put it all into... And we're just going to go in here and add some new text. And that text, let's do it. So this is obviously just a sample, but just to give you an idea here, if we can now save this file in several ways to prepare for print. As we've gone over in other videos, many times we'll want to convert these fonts to outline. And you can watch the other film to see exactly how you do that, but it's quite simple, create outlines. However, in many cases, you will not want to create outlines of the fonts because you're not ready for that stage yet. You might need to adjust this file on a continual basis, but you still want to be able to print it. Export options we can instill, and many different file formats we can use, including CAD. But what you'll see is if we do instead of an export, but a file save as, we can of course save as a native Illustrator, but also an EPS file, an Illustrator EPS file. So let's go ahead and do that now. We'll get several options, which are very important for printing. We can include CMYK in the RGB files, which could be very important for printing. We can choose a level of Adobe PostScript where we want to use, and we can embed fonts for other applications. Now, if we have this checked off, what you'll see is that can cause a big problem. And that's where FlightCheck can come in to help you find these problems, help you find low-res elements of the artwork that are used. So we might think this looks fine on our web page, but will it print correctly? These are the obstacles that stand in the way between web and print, and as designers, we must be very aware of, and also be aware of the fact that even though we might be good designers, we all have our Monday mornings and our Friday afternoons. And that's where FlightCheck comes in. Let's show you how that works with that EPS we just created, for instance. Now, many times, Illustrator for Prepress means that file might be used down the road in other documents, for instance, in desktop publishing layouts like Adobe InDesign or even Quark Express, or even others like Microsoft Publisher, etc., CorelDRAW. And just to give you an example here, if we create a new InDesign document, and you know we can add some text. And then let's just add in that image there, file, place. Go and select that EPS we just created. And we can place it in there. And we can arrange it and all that. And see, it all looks fine and dandy. And we can save this InDesign file. We'll take a closer look here. Okay, so let's pop into FlightCheck here and let's see what happens when we check this InDesign layout that's using the Illustrator artwork we just prepared. And this is supposedly prepared for Prepress use. Thus, it should print perfectly. Let's see what happens when we take the InDesign file with the used fonts and images and drop it on the FlightCheck flight strip. We just drop it up here on the FlightCheck flight strip, and the preflight process initiates. In mere seconds, we get a results window where we can very quickly see there are problems in red and warnings in blue. There we see the EPS image, which we asked to be warned about. Why? Because often EPS images can once again include fonts which might be missing. In this case, we can see it is missing. Now, we know this. We did this on purpose.
But you can see here that the screen and the print font is missing. In the main window, we get all the details on the file. Not only your file, page, and print info, but also your color, fonts, and images. It's in that colors, fonts, and images where we can see right now exactly what we're talking about. We can see we have three missing fonts. We can see the type of font, we can see the version, and we can even see the manufacturer. Very handy if you need to go acquire or buy that font. FlightCheck can help you do that. Here we can see the image which we used. We get a preview of the image with the text we have in there, and we can right away see this file is not ready for prepress use. This Illustrator file has missing printer font, missing screen font, and we even see exactly the font which is missing. So this is key in getting your Illustrator file ready for using in prepress. In this case, using within Adobe InDesign. It should be noted Adobe InDesign's inbuilt preflight will not see this missing font and or any images that are embedded within the EPS. FlightCheck will. Not only will FlightCheck find and pinpoint these problems, it'll also package that InDesign file with all fonts and images, including those used in the EPS file from Illustrator. Very handy. I should also note FlightCheck itself can preflight native Illustrator files and even, for instance, the Illustrator EPS. No problem. It'll allow you to collect this job and include the images. So if you could find that image, you would be able to collect it as well. Very handy for archiving or passing on to the next person in the workflow. FlightCheck will also collect native Illustrator files and Photoshop. Extremely handy.
So as you see, how you save a file for prepress in Illustrator really depends on your final need. In many cases, you will not know that final need till later, or it might change, which is one reason why many people will not flatten the font so quickly or embed font so quickly. There are various options when saving your file or save as within Adobe Illustrator. You can, of course, even place PDFs nowadays, or even native Illustrator files. But saving as Illustrator EPS is still one of the most popular ways to utilize vector artwork that you've created within Illustrator for prepress. Naturally, there's other methods of exporting the file, including a JPEG or TIFF image, which are also fine for static use as well. The most important thing is ensure that your file is using high-resolution artwork, has all the fonts available and or converted to outlines, and a host of other preflight issues which FlightCheck can help you check for and or use the eyeball method, you know, going through bit by bit on your file and looking for potential problems. Over on Markzware.com, you can find more information on FlightCheck under the product section. You can get a full video on how it works, learn more about the ground controls, the heart of FlightCheck, to check not only your Illustrator, InDesign, or Photoshop files, but also the PDF file. There's even a free 30-day demonstration version you can download. So that's been How to Save File for Prepress in Adobe Illustrator, the how-to for today from Markzware. And this is David Dilling from Markzware, signing off.